fresh off the back of the Lionesses' win at the Euros, I've popped down here to Surrey in order to meet up with eFIXX award winners Joltify. They took home the award for EV Installer of the Year, sponsored by EV Comply. And much like the beautiful game, we're about to find out that this is very much a business of two halves. So we stepped into the garage to have a look at the installation, and this is kind of the first half of the business. And the first half of the video, we're looking at the technical installation side, and we've got Martin Cook here, the co-founder of what's now called Joltify. We've moved on from Jolt.
Indeed, we moved on from Jolt to Joltify. We made that transition a couple of months back now.
Very good, excellent. And it's working out very well, and I actually prefer the new name, so you made a good choice there.
Thank you, good.
Very good. So tell me a little bit about the installation. So we've got a classic favourite from eFIXX. We've got the Zappi 2 here. So what made you go for this particular unit in this installation?
So we've gone for the Zappi because we've got a three-phase installation. It's also got the inbuilt pen fault detection, which can obviously reduce the installation cost quite significantly if you're doing a three-phase charger. To have it all built in the RCD as well, makes it a really good unit. And the customer's also talking about potentially getting solar panels as well. And we've actually got quite a long route, so it wraps around very inconspicuously the cable routing around the top of the garage. We then run a separate Ethernet cable to run a three CT clamps to the main three-phase head, and then continue around to the back of the garage with a 100 amp isolator fuse board, Hager board.
That's really interesting. So yeah, so it's a little bit unusual, this installation, because obviously we're in a domestic property, not what you would call a typical domestic property by any means.
It's rather nice property.
It's rather magnificent, but it's got that advantage of a three-phase supply coming in. So how does that help out from a charging point of view?
So with a single phase, you can only obviously have the 7 kilowatts. With the three phase here, they've got a three phase Zappi, so it's running in effect three single phases, so totaling 22 kilowatts of charging capability.
Yeah, that's good. And of course, you're getting that with a slightly lower current flow as well, which means your cable doesn't have to be quite as massive as if you were trying to stick all that down a single phase, which we probably wouldn't recommend. So with that three phase supply coming in, obviously you've said that you've run a separate Ethernet cable.
Yeah.
What type of cable would you normally use on a project? Do you prefer having a separate data cable, or is a particular
no?
So
at Joltify, we try and make everything look as best it can be, or not just look, so it is as best as we can be, as it can be. So we tend to use EV Ultra cable, non-SWA, which obviously contains the Ethernet cable, and also we pair it up with the Linear Fire Clips, the Linear Super Clips, which give that really nice kind of neat finish.
Fantastic. That's and we agree with that, actually. We think that's a brilliant application for the fire clips, and we're big fans of those at eFIXX. As you know, we've done lots of videos, so check those out. And also, so in this case, though, we couldn't use that EV Ultra cable, so why couldn't we use it? Why have we had to use a separate Ethernet on this one?
Because we've got the main service head or main incoming head in a different location to the fuse board. So we didn't want to go into a junction box and then split it just to keep the aesthetics neater. So we've neatly tucked the Ethernet cable behind the 5-core power cable and then just run it directly to the service head and then a power cable back to the fuse board. So it just, again, helps to keep things a little bit neater and more inconspicuous.
Excellent. And it's a really good looking job. We're going to have a look at a little bit more of it now. So Martin, we've just popped over to have a little look at the incoming supply here. I can see you've got your current transformers up here. So what's going on with these? Why do we need three of those?
So we've got three CT clamps on here because we've got a three-phase installation. So they're measuring the load that's going through each individual phase. And the reason we do that is we set the charger up, so the Zappi in this case, to keep below a 60 amp threshold for the property. And the reason we do that is because if we keep the property below 60 amps, we can do something called connect and notify to the DNO.
Okay.
The alternative to that is we have to ask permission from the distribution network operators before we install the charger.
Right.
And that can get quite messy because often they can come back and say no, or they can take a lot of time to come back. But this way we can maximize the installation's ability to supply the charger without having to do that apply to connect process.
Yeah, and it's interesting as well because you've got a three-phase charger installed as well.
Yeah.
And we all know that although you've got that 22 kilowatt potential charging capacity, actually most cars won't allow for that to happen anyway. So I think the car they've got here, we'd say it was about 11 kilowatt charging, we think.
Yeah, so the car they've currently got is a Mercedes, and it can charge up to 11 kilowatts. But I guess with the whole EV world, it's all about future-proofing.
Yes.
Because these cars are coming out, the DC inverters that are built into the cars, they're increasing their capacity. So hopefully in the next couple of years we'll find chargers that can actually utilize that full 22 kilowatts.
Yeah, nice. And it's a good idea to again make use of that connect and notify facility, because it's very unlikely that with the combination of car and charger that we've got here, it's very unlikely to put it above that limit anyway, I guess.
Correct.
Yeah, brilliant.
Correct.
Smart. So we've just stepped into what we could probably consider the plant room here. It's a typical plant room. You've got an Ethernet switch up there, you've got the DB here, and you've got the kids' painting equipment down here. So a very typical domestic situation. What's not typical though is this three-phase dish board. Was there any challenges in connecting into this existing board? It looks like it's pretty much full up now.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much full up, but we had to move some of the individual MCBs just to give us that three-pole MCB for the EV there at the top right. But no, everything else is fairly standard. It's obviously pre-existing, and we've just landed into the bottom into our MCB.
It's good. So you've got three spare ways, but not together. So there's been some jigging about going on there to get that to work. That's good. And one thing I noticed that is particularly pleasing about this installation, obviously on this this main sub-main cable coming in, you've got the old traditional cleats, but that wasn't the way you wanted to go with your lovely new armoured cable. So what have you gone for on there?
So we've actually gone for the linear clips just down there, but we love them. They look so nice, and they're in line with what we do. Just try and make everything as discreet, neat as possible. And these clips, while they have their place, aesthetically, they don't compare.
Absolutely. So not necessarily using those for their fire retention issues in the event of a fire preventing premature collapse, but they just look the business when they're installed, don't they?
Correct. And because we're normally doing cables outside, there's not such an issue, but aesthetically, yeah, you just can't beat them.
Couldn't agree more. We like linear. So Martin, we've looked at that lovely installation of the EV charge point. We've stepped outside and we've got your brilliantly branded EV there. So that's the BMW i3, is that right?
All electric i3.
Very nice.
Yep, helps with the being carbon neutral company.
Absolutely. We're saving the planet, that's good, but obviously, speaking of electric vehicles and the EV charge point you've installed, what's the next logical step really for anyone who's got an EV to have installed on their property?
Solar. So solar's growing massively, and with the cost of energy going up through the roof, more and more of our customers are coming to us saying, look, you've done a great job with the installation. We want to do solar because they want to control the cost of their electricity. Can we start looking into install solar for them?
Yeah, definitely. And are you kind of in a position to start doing that straight away, or is it something that you kind of really carefully thinking about and investing the proper time and money into?
So yeah, the key thing with us and Joltify is we want to do it right.
Yeah.
We don't like making mistakes. We do everything in the best possible way. So I guess we're taking a slow and steady approach. Yeah. We've just done a solar course. We're looking at doing a registration with MCS in the next couple of months. And then we'll be in a place to really start helping our customers with their solar installations, and especially with the Zappi, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, because we know that the Zappi 2 and solar PV, battery storage, it all just combines so beautifully, doesn't it, to give a really economic really kind of boost once it's all installed. It's so much cheaper and easier to keep your EV fueled.
You can't get cheaper than free, can you really?
You can't get cheaper than free. As we like to say here at eFIXX, they'll be driving on sunshine. That's great. Great chatting to you, Martin. Let's go and see what David's up to.
Cheers.
So it was really nice meeting Martin and having a chat with him about the techie installation side of things. But we said this is a video of two halves, and we're now going to talk a bit more about the business side of things. So
sure.
You're not a traditional electrical contractor, David, is that fair to say?
I think that's really fair to say. I said you wouldn't want to give me a screwdriver because I think the business would go bust very quickly.
Very good. But you're bringing the business now to this kind of world. So what's your background? Where have you worked before?
So I suppose when I had a proper job, I used to work for John Lewis, and I used to run John Lewis on Oxford Street. I was the general manager there. So that was like 3,000 people. And I kind of left that about 10 years ago, opened a couple of coffee shops up. I sold them beginning of this year. Mm-hmm. For me, it's about creating something new, looking for businesses that have an opportunity to be something amazing, but also giving something to people as well. And Martin and I, probably about 2 years ago, were walking my dog in Epsom Common, and we thought there must be an opportunity within, you know, the whole EV market and the solar market. And probably fast forward to now, we thought there was a gap in the market where you got the big boys who perhaps we're going for market share and going for sales, but perhaps not always focusing on the customer. Then you've got the smaller individual guys who had do a great job, but there's probably a niche in the market where we said, right, we can probably do the medium-sized jobs, and that's what we started. So 18 months ago, Martin was out with the screwdriver, I was on the phone, and from there to now, we're hoping to take just over £1 million in year 2-3, which is great. We're multi-award winning. Yep. We've won Startup of the Year for Kingston Borough, and also obviously we won install of the year for eFIXX, which was a complete accolade for us.
Just indulge me for a moment here. Sure. So what did it mean to you when you heard that you'd won the eFIXX award?
Amazing. Yeah. Absolutely amazing. The biggest challenge in any business is getting awareness of the brand and get people to know us. We knew that we were good at what we did. We were great at our conversion rates. We were brilliant at what we did. We've got over 200 five-star reviews with Which and Trustpilot, so that's amazing. But we needed people to know about us. So to win eFIXX Award as Installer of the Year was absolutely amazing. And we are exploiting that to the absolute hilt. and hopefully people will actually come to your channel as well, because it's getting recognition for your brand as well. So we're really chuffed.
Fantastic. So those five-star reviews, what would you say is about your kind of business model that sets you apart? Because obviously getting 200 five-star reviews is no mean feat. You know, the harshest critics of the public, you know, as we know here on YouTube. But what makes your business kind of able to do that? What's your key focus that enables it?
So when we first started, what our mission was to help and inform people into EV ownership. Okay. So there's almost a bit of a black hole.
Yeah.
And the industry is moving forward really fast, and it's hard for people to keep up. And people don't really know what they don't know.
Yeah.
So our mission was to say, right, let's inform. Let's be totally independent to all the manufacturers and go out and support people. So we'll do site surveys in people's homes, we'll do it on video, or we'll do it on the telephone, but we'll always put the customer first. And, you know, it's a bit of a cliche, but it's really important.
Yeah.
You know, there's a couple of things because you've got to get right. And one is always exceed what the customer wants. We never overpromise and underdeliver. So an example may be if we turned up to a job and the customer said they had bonding on the gas pipe and they didn't, we'll just do it.
Yeah.
Right? We won't leave that job until we're 100% satisfied. The customer's on their app, they know how to use it, and they're saying, right, okay, so you're 100% satisfied, you know everything works, and then we'll send them the invoice out and say, hey, do you mind giving us a five-star review? And you know, it's not rocket science for us, but it's about doing it right and doing it right every time. And if things go wrong, which they do, we'll stay there until we put it right.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we were discussing off camera earlier the challenges that you had in another life when you were making tea for people at your coffee shops, that you know, it's very difficult to get people's tea right, but it seems that you're getting people's EV installs right, which is you know, probably no less of a challenge.
It's probably because I'm not actually doing it with the screwdriver probably. It's firstly, I think that what you need to do is put yourself in a position of the customer and say, what is that customer looking for, and trying to meet that need. And a really good example is, we'll go to site, if we do an on-site survey, a customer said, right, this is where my car needs to go, and this is where I want my charge point.
Yeah.
And I mean, it was the first install Martin did, and said to the customer, whatever you want is fine, and we'll meet that need.
Yeah.
However, there is an alternative, and that is perhaps put the charge point here, because if you were to ever get a second car, you could then charge both cars. And the customer said, that's just amazing, I would never have thought about it. We'll take you, you know, we'll give you the business. And it's just listening to that customer and trying to support them as much as we can, and that seems to be what's kind of working for us.
And I guess if you try and understand their needs, then even if you don't give them what they thought they wanted, maybe you're giving them more what they need, actually.
Yeah, I think that's the thing.
Helping them to understand why.
And if we can inform, and then we say, look, these are your options, and if you go with that, it's amazing. If you don't, absolutely fine, but what you want to consider is this, and then they can make an informed decision. And hopefully when we leave, they go, do you know what, those guys are amazing.
Yeah.
And then when they want solar put in, they'll maybe phone us back up and say, hey guys, can Joltify come and do solar, you know, or a house rewire or something like that.
Very good. Well, I'm glad we've circled back round to that solar PV future on the sort of the techie install side that we were talking about with Martin a minute ago. But again, from a business side, there's also kind of plans for the future. So where does Joltify go from here? You've got a thriving, good quality business, award-winning business, maybe.
Multi-award-winning business.
Get that right. So what's the next step? Are you content just running where you are and maybe just expanding in terms of, you know, the number of employees in this area, or are we looking bigger than that?
Yeah, okay. Well, I think that's a great question. And I think first and foremost, I think Martin might have already said it, what we won't ever do is overpromise and underdeliver.
Sure.
So we want the first 2 years for us is to get our foundations in place.
Yeah.
So that's what I think we've done now. We're starting to get a really good reputation in the industry and also locally. We're a local company, but we've got national ambition.
Yeah.
So we're hoping to sign up our first franchisee in the near future. And we've got a couple more in the pipeline. So what we ideally want to do is become a national brand through a franchising model. With Martin and I as the real support and drive behind that. Yeah. That would work brilliantly. But what we're looking for are probably one or two people. One, an existing electrician who wants to get into the EV world. Sure. And we'll support them with setting up the business and getting the leads and that yeah. type of thing. The alternative is someone who's never been an electrician before. Mm-hmm. They'll go on the training course. Mm-hmm. They'll then come to us. We'll give them an intensive EV baptism, I suppose, yeah. And then they'll go off and start doing their installs. Okay. So people who want to become electrician, great route, and also those who are existing yeah. But want to be perhaps part of a family, which yeah. I think sometimes electricians can be quite isolating in the
yeah.
role.
Yeah, do you know, that's really interesting that you brought that out. Actually, that's a keen observation of the electrical industry, and it's something that we do notice when we're, you know, sort of on social media with some of our followers and other people, that yeah, you can end up feeling a little bit kind of in a box, you know, and you're not sure what other people are doing, if they're having the same challenges you are. So I guess, you know, it's interesting because I'm not aware of very many electrical businesses that are setting up a franchise in those terms, but it sounds like you're doing it under very kind of controlled conditions because you want to keep that quality.
And that's absolutely right. Yeah. For us, it's I suppose if you think of one of the best franchise model is McDonald's, yeah. and every time you go to McDonald's, it doesn't matter where you are in the world, it's bizarre, it's the true. same, it's yeah. really good, and that's the only way we will be,
yeah.
And that's the only way you don't damage your brand,
yeah.
and I think by the way in which we will support the new franchisees and nurture them and give clarity to standards, and you know what, you get it right first time,
yeah.
it's a lot easier, you yeah. haven't got to do any retrospective work, so go in, plan it properly, go and execute it perfectly. Mm-hmm. Customers loving what you've done, they'll refer you, so therefore you've got a lead generation source. And also operationally, that kind of installation is complete.
Yeah.
You then can tick the box, you know, I think you contact D&O, I think that's what Martin does,
yeah.
and then we move on to the next one in the afternoon. And yeah. It's a really good model that yeah. just kind of replicates itself.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, what an absolutely brilliant insight into your kind of business thinking and also the future of your business, and who knows, maybe the future of your business if you're watching. You might want to get in touch if you're interested in franchising.
Please do.
Good stuff. Thanks ever so much for the chat, David. Really enjoyed that.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Thanks.
While filming with Joltify today, I've been really impressed by two different things. The first is the way that David and Martin have brought together two different personalities, two different skill sets, and two different strengths in order to build a company that really is more than the sum of its parts. And that emphasis on customer experience is clearly so important, and it obviously works, because actually while we've been working here, the client has popped out of the house and started making inquiries about having solar PV installed on the roof in order to help out with charging the EV. So they're obviously doing something right. The other thing I've been really impressed by is the reassurance that the future of the electrical industry really is in safe hands. There's great businesses out there, there's great people running them, and they're working really hard to make sure that the reputation of the electrical industry is maintained and held high. And now they're looking to expand that out to future situations as well. So it's been absolutely brilliant for me. I've really enjoyed it. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, please check out these videos here. Thank you very much for watching.